हेलो एवरीवन, नमस्ते। मेरा नाम गीतांजलि है और इस साल CSE 2019 UPSC एग्ज़ाम में मेरे को 32nd रैंक प्राप्त हुआ है। एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई लाइक टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट एंथ्रोपोलॉजी ऑप्शनल की स्ट्रैटेजी मेरी, एंड कैसे मैंने आई हैव गिवन दो मेंस मैंने दी है एंथ्रोपोलॉजी के साथ, तो एंड आई हैव हैड टू वेरी डिफरेंट एक्सपीरियंसेस। 2018 में इतना अच्छा नहीं रहा मेरा अटैम्प्ट, और 2019 में ज़्यादा, मतलब आई एम गेसिंग कि अच्छा ही हुआ होगा बिकॉज अभी मार्क्स तो नहीं आए हैं। बट आई'd लाइक टू टेल यू हाउ आई इम्प्रूव्ड अपॉन 2018 से 19 में, हाउ आई इम्प्रूव्ड अपॉन माय स्कोर इन एंथ्रोपोलॉजी। सो देर आर अ फ्यू थिंग्स दैट आई वुड लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट टुडे। फर्स्ट वुड बी दैट व्हाई आई चोज दिस ऑप्शनल। सेकेंड, आई वुड लाइक टू टच अपॉन यू नो वॉट आर माई ऑप्शनल रिसोर्सेज एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट। एंड थर्ड समथिंग दैट आई वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट इज वॉट एग्जैक्टली डिड आई डू टू प्रिपेयर फॉर माई एंथ्रोपोलॉजी ऑप्शनल, राइट? सो वन ऑफ द रीजन्स दैट आई चोज एंथ्रोपोलॉजी एज एन ऑप्शनल इज माई बैकग्राउंड विज जूलॉजी, एंड ऑल्दो दैट इज ऑल्सो अवेलेबल इन UPSC एज एन ऑप्शनल, आई लुक्ड एट द यू नो प्रीवियस ईयर पेपर्स फॉर जूलॉजी एंड एंथ्रोपोलॉजी एंड ऑल्सो सोशियोलॉजी, एंड वेन आई सॉ द जूलॉजी पेपर्स, वेरी फ्रेंकली स्पीकिंग, I did not feel like, you know, I wanted to invest so much time and energy in order to study the, you know, the zoology all over again. It had already been 2 years jab se mera graduation hua tha, and zoology wapas padhne ka mera man nahi tha. So the very simple reason why I took anthropology was because I didn't feel like taking zoology, and anthropology has a few areas that overlap with zoology, which is part of my liking. Like, I like the genetics and evolution part of anthropology, which is why I chose anthropology over zoology, and because of that overlapping area as well. And the third thing that I had referred to while choosing this optional was the resources. So I felt that, you know, there are more resources available for anthropology as compared to zoology, and this was even before, you know, 2017 Anudeep सर ही सिक्योर्ड अ फर्स्ट रैंक, सो ये उससे भी पहले था, बट देर वॉज स्टिल इनफ रिसोर्सेज एंड गाइडेंस फॉर एंथ्रो, सो विच इज़ वाई दीज आर द 3 मेन रीजन्स वाई आई चोज एंथ्रो। ऑल्सो यू नो इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट, एंड एनीबडी हु इज़ इंटरेस्टेड इन ह्यूमन सोसाइटी इन जनरल विल बेनिफिट फ्रॉम स्टडिंग अबाउट एंथ्रोपोलॉजी। सो दीज वर द रीजन्स दैट आई चोज द ऑप्शन। नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू माई रिसोर्सेज, mainly there are 5 breakdowns of anthropology. First is the physical anthropath, second is the social anthropath. For physical anthropology I referred to PNAT, and I supplemented it with the internet quite a lot. For social anthropology, my main resource in 2018 it was basically Braintree throughout, however in 2019 I supplemented the Braintree with Muniratnam Notes, which is, I feel, it's good enough for socio-cultural anthropology. For theories, especially chapter 6, that is anthropological theories, most of it was for me from the internet, and I had spent a considerable amount of time researching, and that is what I did for theories. And apart from that, Indian anthropology, Nadeem Hasnain has a standard book, and I refer to a lot of IGNU notes for Indian anthropology. And these IGNU notes are available completely free. It's Masters in Anthropology ke PDFs are available online. Wo aap dekh sakte hain. And in the same for social anthropology also, I refer to IGNU notes for sociology. To kuch aise topics hai jaise social structure and, you know, society and the concept of social function and all of that. That is something that is very well explained in the sociology IGNU notes, right? And remaining was tribal anthropology. For that I referred to Khaka committee reports, and a lot of it was supplemented by the internet, because kuch aise topics hai tribal anthro mein jo standard books mein available nahi hai, jaise ki communalism, regionalism, ethnicity, all of that is basically a lot of current affairs that I had to gather, you know, the latest names, what all tribal conflicts were happening in the northeast, left wing extremism. So for that I refer to internet a lot. And in general there are a few topics in anthro such as evolution, especially evolution, archaeological anthropology, and you know, that's the ancestry of human evolution, that is Homo erectus, Homo habilis, things like that. So what happens is what is there in the books, especially in PNAT, is very outdated, and uske baad kafi sari research aur kafi sare fossils wagera discover ho chuki hain, jisse information is completely updated right now. So even for evolution and even for human ancestry as well as archaeological anthropology, I would suggest that you please refer to लेटेस्ट सोर्सेज एंड लेटेस्ट रिसर्च विच इज़ अवेलेबल ऑन द यू नो ऑन डिफरेंट वेबसाइट्स रिसर्च वेबसाइट्स एंड इट विल बी वेरी नाइस फॉर यू टू कोट सम ऑफ दीज रिसर्चेज एंड द यू नो ऑथर बिहाइंड दोज स्टडीज इन योर एग्जाम सो दैट यू नो दैट गिव्स यू दैट एक्स फैक्टर विच इज़ डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर पीपल एंड दिस वॉज अ बेसिक ओवरव्यू ऑफ माई रिसोर्सेज अपार्ट फ्रॉम दीज Anthropology thankfully has a very nice tradition of toppers, you know, putting up all their notes and all their PDFs, all their test series answers and all their question answers, whatever they wrote. So those I referred to very liberally. So Sachin Gupta sir's notes were there. I referred to Anadeep sir's strategy, Sachin Gupta sir notes. There is Harsha Koeshri sir whose test series is available online. And so all of these resources were actually invaluable in my preparation because in 2019 I did not take a test series and it was very easy. Despite that, it was very easy for me to just write answers in my own house and then, you know, just correct it against what the topper is doing because they know what the gold standard is for anthro. And, you know, a lot of value addition that I received from Sachin Gupta sir's notes and I hope to actually thank him very, you know, personally if I meet him. And coming to my 2018 and 2019, the difference between my preparation is, as I mentioned in my previous video as well, in 2018, I picked up anthro only after my prelims. Usse pehle maine ye galti kar di thi ki anthro theek se prepare nahi kiya tha prelims se pehle. So, jab usko prelims ke baad pick up kiya, to obviously there was this time crunch where, you know, for the first time I'm reading everything, to usko revision karne mein bhi dikkat hogi. And then I had to, you know, cut down on how much I would be able to complete. So I could not complete the syllabus. And simultaneously, I had also taken a test series where Surbhi ma'am was guiding me. And she was very nice to me as a mentor because she spent a lot of time reading my absolute trash answers and, you know, things that lacked content. But she sat and she gave me a lot of attention and told me, okay, this is how you write, this is how you put in a diagram here and there. So that guidance was invaluable. And I think, you know, even with limited content, but because I knew how to write better answers and structure them, that is probably why I was able to clear the mains that year. And just to give you an idea, I scored around a 270 in anthropology in 2018, and my main resource for that was Braintree. And just to give you a review of Braintree, it is a good resource, I felt, for someone who is beginning, because that's the one, you know, consolidated resource that you have for almost all subjects within anthropology, and you don't really need to run around looking here and there, but it is wholly inadequate. So that is something that you can read for conceptual clarity, maybe a little bit, but I firmly believe that you cannot score 300 above in anthro by reading just one book. So that's the change that I created in 2019, was that I supplemented every topic I saw against, you know, topper answers, and I saw that, you know, is it adequate? Do I have adequate content for a 250 words answer or a 200 words answer? And if I did not, then I would refer to different sources to see. So just to give you a brief overview of the Braintree material, it is adequate for a first reading, like because it is one consolidated source jahan pe bahut sare, you know, different subjects of anthropology ek hi kitab mein hai, to matlab aapko idhar udhar jana nahi padta hai ek reading karne ke liye anthropology mein. Lekin agar if you want to score a 300 and above in anthropology, I think the Braintree book is not adequate and you will have to refer to different sources for different topics. So this is what I did differently in 2019, is Braintree ko chhod ke, I referred to many different sources, jaise, like I mentioned, Muni Ratnam and IGNU notes and all of that, for value addition to my notes. And the way I knew that my content was inadequate is because I started writing answers. And based on that, then I would judge against what the toppers had written in that year, or, you know, Sachin Gupta sir and all of those other toppers who have put up their PDFs. I would refer to them and I would see ki, you know, there's a shortage in my content. I don't have enough examples. I have not made diagrams. I have not structured, you know, some dimensions are missing. Jaise generally relevance you have to give, or if there is a current affairs thing that you can incorporate, you should. And all of that was missing, and that you realize only when you, you know, compare against it. And then there were some areas jahan pe factually I was incorrect, and conceptually, you know, I did not have enough content. This is especially true for socio-cultural anthropology, which was my weak spot, and so for that I had to refer to different sources. And that is generally the trend what has been. I have spoken to people who have scored above 300 in anthro, and even they concur with me that But they are the ones, in fact, who have guided me and told me that you do need to refer to multiple sources for anthro. And then this comes into, this, you know, brings me to what is note making in anthropology. So I believe for your optional, it is important to have notes on every topic. And those notes have to be made in such a way that they are directed towards answering questions in the exam. So what happens is when you refer to multiple sources, ek jagah pe usko consolidate karna zaruri ho jata hai. Kyunki again, you know, like I've spoken about it in the previous video that you have to revise everything. So you cannot revise jab har 3-4 jagah pe ek topic hai. So you'll have to sit and make notes for everything. And you have to make notes in such a way ki aap answer kaise likhenge exam mein. To aapke notes bhi uski hisab se hone chahiye ki, you know, you have put enough dimensions. Agar aapko diagram isme possibility lag rahi hai, to aap usi mein diagram bana dijiye notes. सो दैट आपको एग्जाम में सोचना ना पड़े कि यू नो कौन सा डायग्राम यहाँ पे बन सकता है कि नहीं. सो एंड यू नो सो नोट मेकिंग हैज़ टू बी डन फॉर एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, दैट्स व्हाट आई बिलीव. एंड देन दिस ब्रिंग्स मी टू आंसर राइटिंग इन एंथ्रोपोलॉजी. अ लॉट ऑफ योर आंसर राइटिंग कैन बी डन इफ़ यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन इट इन योर नोट्स. मतलब आप अगर अपने नोट्स को इस हिसाब से बनाओ कि आपके आंसर राइटिंग अच्छी रहे, कि यू नो यू थिंक ऑफ द एग्जाम व्हेन यू आर मेकिंग नोट्स, कि यू नो 250 वर्ड्स का लेंथ होना चाहिए, 200 वर्ड्स, 150 वर्ड्स, 10 मार्कर्स, 15 मार्कर्स, और उसमें आप ऐड कर दो यू नो रेलेवेंस एंड यू ऐड डायग्राम्स इन योर नोट्स इटसेल्फ, फिर आंसर राइटिंग में आपको टाइम नहीं लगेगा. एंड दिस ऑल्सो हेल्प्स इन कम्प्लीटिंग द पेपर ऑन टाइम, बिकॉज जनरली ऐसे होता है कि यू नो लोगों का पेपर कम्प्लीट नहीं हो पाता क्योंकि टाइम कम है, लिखना ज़्यादा है और उसमें सोचना भी है. अभी क्या हो रहा है कि एंथ्रोपोलॉजी का पैटर्न भी थोड़ा चेंज हो रहा है. लाइक पहले ऐसा होता था कि काफ़ी क्वेश्चंस रिपीट हो जाते थे पिछले साल के, अभी दे आर चेंजिंग इट अ लिटिल बिट, दैट इज़ व्हाट आई बिलीव. एंड सो इट्स गोइंग टू टेक टाइम टू थिंक अबाउट इट ऑल्सो. सो द वे यू सेव टाइम इज़ बाय व्हेन यू आर मेकिंग नोट्स इटसेल्फ, देन थिंक ऑफ द डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस दैट दे कैन आस्क. फॉर एग्जाम्पल देयर वॉज अ क्वेश्चन, यू नो, फैमिली एज द सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और समथिंग अलॉन्ग दैट लाइन. सो इफ दे कैन आस्क फैमिली, वाई डोंट यू वाइल मेकिंग नोट्स थिंक अबाउट ऑल द अदर थिंग्स दैट दे कैन आस्क इन, यू नो, इन टर्म्स ऑफ सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल टैबू एज अ सोशल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और समथिंग लाइक दैट. सो जस्ट क्रिएट अ फ्रेमवर्क एंड do that in your notes as well, so that you can recreate that in the answers that you make in your exam without having to think so much about structuring. And answer writing practice I have done in 2018 and 2019. So in 18 I took a test series like I mentioned with Surbhi ma'am, and that was my answer writing. I did not write answers at home. But in 2019 I chose not to take an answer, you know, test series because I had already acquired the basics. And I did not feel like, you know, it becomes difficult to manage time when there are more than one test series going on. So what I did is that I started writing answers in the home, and then I checked them against topper copies. And I had a friend, Ananya Kirti, who's also, you know, a rank holder this year. So we used to sit and prepare the answers together, and we used to you know, hash out what could be better. We used to check each other's answers and things like that. So that is what worked for me this year. I would not recommend it to anybody. Like a lot of people give test series and anthro and they benefit from that. However, I am not one of them, and I just want to bring that out because I would like to say that it's a possibility. It is not out of the world for you to not take a test series for your optional. And this is what I wanted to refer to about my difference in 2018 and 2019. Now coming to the last thing that I wanted to say about anthropology is a few, you know, overarching rules or do's or don'ts that I think are required. First is you need to make your answers relevant. So if they are asking about, you know, something about evolution, if they're asking about human genetics, things like that, one of the good ways of making your answer relevant is to bring out current affairs, especially in the conclusion. So if it is something about human genetics, kindly bring out in current affairs, you know, how human genetics is being used, like CRISPR-Cas9, you are editing human genes to, you know, maybe create designer babies or have eventually, you know, neo-eugenics that has been spoken about. Try to bring out the relevance of every topic. And if you sit and think about it, there is a relevance to everything because anthropology is the study of man. So that is a good way to distinguish your answers from other people. And eventually, you know, essentially it is a competitive exam. So you need to be able to write different and write better. So one is the content and then is the value addition. So content you will get by referring to different sources. Value addition you have to do on your own by, again, you can refer to toppers, you can refer to other people's answers, you can refer to the internet, or you can refer to current affairs. But you need to keep, you know, while you are studying this exam, you need to keep your mind and ear open, you know, you need to keep your eyes and ears open about this thing and incorporate them in your notes itself. That is one thing. Another thing that you need to focus upon is diagrams. Of course, anthropology gives you a lot of leeway to make diagrams, especially in the physical anthro part, but also in socio-cultural anthro. And apart from that, anthropology as a subject, although, you know, I've mentioned this a lot of times, it's that there are a lot of resources available for anthro. So please look at what toppers have done. They are the golden standards, like I have repeated. I myself will be sharing everything online. I have a Telegram channel. There are other toppers like Yogesh Patil sir, who has cleared with 63 rank this year, and rank 22 Bandar Patki is also, you know, from anthro. So we'll all be sharing our strategies and our PDFs. So please refer to them as well. And so this is what I wanted to say regarding anthropology, and thank you for watching DKP.